Hello everybody, my name is Kosmicosine, and welcome back to another episode of SkyWars on the Hive server. So, I actually didn't do a video yesterday. I know, this is shocking. It actually is kind of shocking, because I pride myself on my consistency. Although I think that's like 2 videos missed in the past 2 months, so it's not very good. I had like a streak of like 2 years going on prior. But yeah, I mean, recently I've just been pretty busy, so... I talked about this last time I skipped a video, which I think was, like I said, about 2 months ago, maybe even 1 month ago. I've been getting, like, really busy, like, even just doing a video a day right now, like I'm doing right now. I barely have any free time, to be honest. And, I mean, okay, I'm not trying to make a sob story here. To be honest, if I didn't do a video at all, it wouldn't give me much more free time, so I truly don't mind doing a video. Making videos, well, when I say that doing a video takes up my free time, I don't think that's a good way to put it. I guess I use my free time on this video. It's not like I'm not obligated to do this at all. I don't make any good money from this. It's not my job or anything. It's just fun. I have no obligation to do this. So, this is how I spend my free time. I'm at least a good chunk of it. That's a better way to see it, I guess. But yeah, I understand when I said that it sounded kind of off, like, you know, it takes up so much of my free time, boo-hoo. If I really didn't want to do this, I just straight up wouldn't do it, but I just find it fun. I think it's a good way to spend free time, yeah, some fun, like, get to play video games, get to talk over it, so it's not just, I don't know. I do find it more fun to actually just play SkyWars while talking over it. So, yeah, I would play SkyWars normally, but, you know, there's no reason not to if I can just record with it. But I just find video editing fun, and just, you know, why not do videos? So, you know, but yeah, like I said, I am really busy, though. That part's true. I am really busy, some, you know, certain, obviously, videos shouldn't be my priority, so certain things take priority over videos. I always do my videos after I do everything else that I need to do during the day. It's like, I make sure I don't prioritize this over anything else, which I hope you guys understand, but, okay, why is it laggy? It's like, just, oh my gosh, it's so laggy. Holy crap, it's laggy. Okay, I actually know why. Something was downloading. Okay, you stop that download, Steam. Okay, thank you, Steam. So, there we go. Now we're good. Now we're good. Hey, all good now. Alright, so yeah, I mean, just... I'm not getting more busy. Like, there's nothing in the foreseeable future that's happening that's gonna make me more busy. I'm just saying that, like... Whenever I miss a video, it's not because I got lazy. I always try to do a video when I can. Last night, literally, when I finished everything I had to do... it was like 11 o'clock, and I wouldn't have even got, if it's 11 o'clock, I already won't get a full 8 hours of sleep, so if I did a video, I'd prolong that by like 45 minutes, so, that's including uploading and editing and everything. That's assuming that once I upload it, I can just sleep, like, put my computer in lock and then just go to bed, because I don't have to watch it upload, up to that point. When I render the video, I have to wait till it's done rendering so I can actually upload, but once it's uploaded and put, like, then, like, if it's uploading, then there's nothing I have to do. If it's all titled and scheduled and everything, like that, I just can let it upload. I don't need to do anything to it, but, I don't know. Hi, you sure about that? Sure about what? Oh, sure about the bridge. I don't know, you sure about it? Huh? You like the bridge? I like the bridge. How about this? What are you gonna do about this? Huh? Yeah. I bet you didn't have Airbridge in mind. I bet you didn't have this in mind. Hi. Better not have an arrow. If you have bows, then I'm gonna murder you. That doesn't make much sense, actually. I think you would be the one murdering me in this situation. That's just if I'm being honest. Hey, I tried not to knock you off. My plan was to knock you off. I'm still gonna knock you off. Aw, I had a little bit of hope there. He was, like, walking off towards the edge, so I thought, okay, I don't know why I went to the title screen. That was an accident. I thought he was walking towards the edge, so I'm like, that was dumb, but I mean, I had nothing to lose. I just thought, you know what, he's kind of moving towards the edge, so, maybe he had to get knock him off. I had a little bit of hope there. I'd have hard, I hit him for, like, 3 times before he actually finished me, so, hoping I could knock him off there, but I couldn't, so, you know. But yeah, I mean, if I ever do miss a video, then it's not because I didn't want to, it's just, literally, I didn't even realize that I hadn't made a video until, like, 11 o'clock, and that was when I finished everything. I was like, alright, anything else I want to do today? And then I'm like, oh yeah, before I go to bed, I'm like, oh yeah, I didn't do that. But, you know, I'm not gonna ruin my sleeping schedule because of it. My sleeping schedule is already pretty much ruined, but, you know. Alright. Yay. Okay, so, you know. Cool stuff. Guess we're just waiting for people to join. No one seems to be joining, though. Five people? Usually once two people join, everyone joins until it gets full really quickly. But that's not happening right now, so... Alright, now remember, now we got people. Yeah! Can we get more people than seven people? It would be nice if we could get more people than seven people. Well, it requires 11 players to start. Why is people joining so slowly? Why are people joining so slowly? You gotta fix that grammar. Alright, can it not be this garbage? I'm probably gonna join another server. It's gonna be faster. Oh, gosh. Watch the server fill up as soon as I leave. What did I just do? Is this the survival games hub? Wow, I haven't been here in a long time. It's totally different. Anyways, I meant to just click SkyWars again. Well, the server's probably already filled up after I left. That's dumb, but I mean, I don't want to wait forever. So. What the heck? Am I dying? What is that sound? I don't like that sound. I don't like that sound. What the heck was that? What was that sound, you know? That was really creepy. What the heck was that? What the heck was that? If I was playing by myself, I would probably just close the game right now and just curl up and cry. Okay, I wouldn't curl up and cry, but I probably would stop playing because that was weird. Yeah, I don't know what the heck that was. I have it on video. Is that something in 1.9? I don't know what the heck that was. Was there anything in the hub that caused it? There's no mob I know that does that. Is that some new mob? I know there's like a new end mob, but they don't spawn. Why would it spawn on the hub? In the SkyWars hub of all places. I have no clue what that was. I want to look up on the Minecraft wiki after that, see if they added any new spooky noises. That's not the new ambience noise. I mean, I know that. I listened to that already. You know those noises that play when you're close to a dark cave? Those creepy ones? They added a new one in 1.9, but it's not that. I actually listened to that. Myself, just so I'd be prepared for it if I ever heard it, because I hate those noises. Basically, I'm a wimp when it comes to Minecraft. It's spooky, it spooks me for some reason. Minecraft, it's pretty spooky, though, I will stand by that. It's, especially if playing single player. Only if you're playing single player, pretty much. I mean, it's not, if you're playing multiplayer, then it's really not scary at all, but if you're playing single player, it is pretty spooky. What was that? I'm really kind of creeped up right now, because, I mean, I know that has to be a Minecraft sound, and no, it wasn't coming in the room, because I took off one of my earphones. I'm wearing headphones, so, like, I took one of them off my ear, because I wanted to make sure it actually wasn't coming from my house or anything, it was coming from the game, so that's creepy. I mean, it definitely sounded like a Minecraft sound, like, that would definitely fit in as, like, an ambience noise or something, or whatever the cool kids call them. Are you running from me? Or are you chasing me or something? Like, what's actually happening here? Hey, you're gonna get knocked off. Aren't you? Bye-bye. See you later. Actually, see you never, because you're gonna fall there for all of eternity. Actually, you die. But I like to think that you just fall for all of eternity. That's really depressing to think about, actually. Dang it, man. Really, the concept of actual eternity is scary. Like, everyone's like, oh man, I wish I was immortal so that I could- immoral. I said immoral, like that. I said that. I meant to say immortal. They're both actual words, it's just that, you know, I would hope most people wouldn't want to be immoral, although, to be fair, more morality is pretty much completely subjective, just depending on where you were raised, but how you were raised, I guess. But, you know, regardless, I would hope nobody would want to be that. Anyways, immortal, with a T. Okay, shut up. All right, anyways. Wow, I sounded furious at myself. I told myself to shut up with such passion. I was really annoyed at myself, gotta be honest. Trying to get it off, this is an interesting topic. I want to talk about an interesting topic, and I don't want my garbage commentary to get into the way, because my comments, I'm gonna knock you up before you kill me with your dumb iron sword. Dang it, with your dumb iron sword. Okay, I want to talk about this topic, though. It's interesting, it's kind of creepy. Anyways, everyone's like, oh man, I wish I was immortal, so, you know, I couldn't die. I don't want to hear the sound again. Please don't play the sound again. Better not play the sound. It was around the fountain area. Don't play that stupid sound. Alright, well, there's something in that hub that must trigger it. Anyway, so, everyone's like, oh, I wish I was immortal. But, like, if you actually think about it, okay, so for a few billion years, that'd be cool, you know? A few billion years. You'd get to see how Earth plays out. Hopefully there's not some civilization-ending event that just leaves you in the rubble of humanity for ever, and you're on Earth. But hey, at least you'll be on Earth. My point is, you'll be on Earth. You'll have things to do. There'll be lots of mental and physical stimulation to be had on Earth. If you were, we're immortal. We're assuming you don't have to eat or you don't have to live in proper conditions. Like, it doesn't have to have an atmosphere. Like I said, if some sort of big atmosphere, like asteroid, just jumped into the Earth, like hit the Earth at some point, maybe like say like 100 years or something, that like just destroyed everything, destroyed all life, destroyed the Earth's habitat. It would still, you'd still survive because nothing can kill you, even bad conditions on Earth, no atmosphere and such. So we're assuming that. Assuming that even if everything was wiped clean on Earth, you'd be able to live. So, but hey, you would still be on Earth. But here's the problem. Eventually, Earth will just straight up just go, it'll go away. It'll die. Because the sun is, I think it's going to be, well, I don't want to say it's going to, like, be evaporated or disintegrated. I don't think that can happen. But the point is, you'll be really, it might actually be swallowed by the sun. So you'll be inside the sun. That won't be fun. I mean, we're assuming you don't feel pain either. Actually, well, should you feel pain? Well, I mean, well, you're immortal, so it doesn't really matter if you feel pain or not. Like, it's actually really bad if you don't feel pain in real life. Some people are, like, insensitive to pain, which is actually bad, because they don't know when they're hurting themselves, and they can just hurt themselves and not even know it. But the thing is, if you're immortal, then it doesn't matter if you're being hurt, because you're not actually being hurt. So we're assuming you also don't feel pain. So anyways, you'd be inside the sun. We're assuming you're on Earth, of course, because, you know, where else would you be if you were human? You'd be inside the sun, because eventually the sun's going to expand into a red giant after it runs out of its current fuel supply. It'll expand and get, like, I think 100 times bigger. 100, I don't know if that's in radius or degrees or diameter or whatever, but either it's going to get really big. It's going to either get really close to the Earth and completely roast the Earth, which will kill all life on it except for you, unless humanity has gone off the Earth, but in which case Earth would still be uninhabited. We just wouldn't be on it either way, whether we're off it or on it. What you could hope is that there is some, that some descendant of the human race is leaving Earth before that time, or has left Earth long before that, so that the optimistic scenario is that humanity was never wiped out and they eventually became a much, well, I mean, if we're talking millions and billions of years, then whatever humans' descendants are millions and billions of years from now would be completely unrecognizable from humans today, but you know, you could kind of, by that time, everyone would know you're immortal. I don't think you could hide it from anyone at that point. So they're assuming that they know you're immortal, so they know that you look like old humans or whatever. This is getting really specific. Anyway, so I'm trying to go through a timeline of what it would be like. I mean, it's cool. So okay, let's go with the optimistic scenario, just so you have some more time. We'll see why it doesn't really matter, but you know, we'll just do the optimistic scenario for now, so you at least have some more time with that. So let's assume that humanity gets off the Earth before it gets roasted. So you're part of this, you know, interstellar civilization. It's fun, it's cool. Maybe not even interstellar civilization, maybe it's just in the solar system. Let's say a space-faring civilization. Actually, let's say that, because that's more realistic. It doesn't have to be interstellar, but just in the solar system, maybe they've set up some sort of giant space station or colonize another planet in the solar system. One of those things. Can I not die while I'm talking about this? Why can't I talk about cool things without being killed? Why? Well, I'm gonna finish this, because it's cool. It's a cool topic. So, we're assuming that. So, let's just say you're in the solar system. I'm going to is it realistic? Well, it's realistic to inhabit the solar system, not interstellar travel. To be honest, I think it's kind of unrealistic that humanity will go that far, but we're gonna go with that anyway. So we're assuming that humanity gets to that point, and they inhabit the solar system, so planets and space stations and cool stuff like that. But eventually, we're talking really, really long time, much longer than it took for Earth to actually die out. Eventually, the sun will run out of fuel, and it'll become a white dwarf. I mean, you could still orbit around it, but after this, we're talking billions and I think even trillions of years now, if we're getting to the white dwarf stage. Eventually, the white dwarf will even sizzle out, which is the remnant of a sun after it uses up all of its fuel. It's really small and dense star. But eventually, that will run out of fuel. I think that's in trillions of years. So by this point, we're talking trillions of years. If there's still a civilization, then it's probably, like, godlike to you. Probably can't even keep up with, well, if you were there every step of the way, then maybe. But the thing is, you wouldn't actually biologically change, nor would any single individual of whatever species that is, because, you know, the whole point of evolution is that you change. That species change, not individuals. So you wouldn't change, but the species as a whole would change. So you would still say you would still be a human of this time period, but people in the future would be. It's not that individuals evolved. It's that individuals biologically stay the same. It's that, like, over time the species eventually just became different. Yeah, I'm not gonna give a lecture on evolution now, but you know, I'm assuming most of you have taken that in school already. All right, but you know, at that point, eventually all the stars will run out of fuel, and at that point you're basically screwed because there's basically no energy. The universe will have expanded so much that, because the universe is expanding, the universe will have expanded so much that everything will be super far apart from each other, and nothing fun will happen. You'll be without stars, you'll be without energy, and you'll kind of be in a completely sterile, really boring environment for all of eternity. You think trillions of years sounds like a lot? Well, is it literally nothing? I mean, infinity isn't a number, so you can't make, like, a ratio of Trinity? I think I tried to combine the words a trillion and infinity. Trifinity. I think trinfinity, that's the better way to say it. You can't make a ratio of a trillion to infinity, because infinity isn't really a real number, but either way, it's for all intents and purposes, we can say that it's absolutely nothing. And at some point, even the last... Well, we're assuming that you're above the forces of nature, too, that would kill you. No matter what happens, your consciousness will stay intact. So, you'll just... At some point, even the super advanced race or whatever, if we're going with that topic, then... If we're going with that idea, that'll even... There's nothing they could do to stop it. But if you're literally immortal, then even... Like, if you're even so immortal that you could... This is completely hypothetical, by the way. No one can do this. You couldn't be. You simply could not be. But if you were somehow so immortal that you were above the forces of nature, then at some point you would just be in a completely sterile environment with literally nothing to interact with. It would just be you and nothing. It would be absolutely nothing, because I think everything would just evaporate. To be honest, I'm not too up to date on my universe ending. I'm not too up to date on my universe ending hypotheses. But I think one of them is that at some point the individual atoms will actually rip themselves apart. That's not because of the expansion, I think. It's just because it's some other thing called the Big Rip. Like I said, I'm not too brushed up on my universe-ending theories. By the way, at some point, you would just be even if that didn't happen, you would still just be in a completely sterile environment, and there'd be no way to really bring yourself, there'd be nothing to build with, there'd be nothing to entertain yourself with. And it'd be for literally forever. Literally forever. It's so weird to comprehend that. Like, it would be for literally forever. And that's really hard to comprehend, and that's why that's pretty much it, to be honest. I mean, I can go more detail. I can really talk about this for a while, because that entire hypothetical question is something that I've thought about for a long time. Just being immortal and just infinity and eternity as a whole, I think they're really interesting concepts. But I definitely would not want to be immortal, because sure, I would want to be immortal if I was able to end my existence. Like, I would want to be immortal from everything else, but if I wanted to end, well, this is completely hypothetical. Well, this can't happen. This can't happen. But if it were possible, I would choose to be immortal if I could choose when to end my existence. So I would chill out, be immortal, see what happens with humanity and maybe the universe. But at some point, when everything's, there's nothing to do and there's nothing to interact with, then I would just, you know what, there's no point in chilling out here anymore. So I don't know. I think this got way too deep, and I'm actually using the word deep because this is definitely is too deep for. I've completely forgotten about the creepy sound, by the way. But I don't want to think about it. It's really creepy. I'm gonna look that up. What that deal was with the sound. But I don't know. I mean, I know the people misuse the word deep now, like, oh, it's so deep, just because something may be serious. But this definitely is a deep topic for a Minecraft video. I mean, we can say that. Just a silly SkyWars video definitely is. An interesting one to think about, lots of possibilities. So it is literally deep, because there's so many different things to think about with the topic. It's not just superficial. There's a lot of concepts to consider. So it's a really interesting topic. I really like it. I don't know. I know I talk about some of these things sometimes, science, just stuff like this. I know some of you guys like it. I've asked you before. People, you guys said you like this kind of stuff. So I mean, I like talking about this stuff too. It's just what I'm interested in. I like it. It's cool. Yeah. I mean, hey, that's pretty much it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys later. Bye. Hey, thanks for watching my video. If you want to watch the previous video that I've made, you can click the video on the left. If you want to watch the next video that I've made, you can click the video on the right. If my next video is already uploaded by the time you watch this, that is. Whoa, what the heck? You're like, what the heck? What the heck is this? You're moving like a professional. What is this? That skeleton was moving like a professional. Did you see that? Actually, I think that's new 1.9 stuff. Someone just Steam messaged me. Sorry.